Israel. I love you, love there, your tents, O Jacob, your dwelling places, O Israel.
Lord of every human
miracles that happen each and every day, miracles which all too often we just take for granted and don't even realize that they are miracles. Susan will chant the Hebrew, and we will join together in the English response. Blessed is the eternal our God, ruler of the universe, who has implanted mind and instinct within every living being. Blessed is the eternal our God, who has made me a Jew. Blessed is the eternal our God, who has made me to be free. Blessed is the eternal our God, who opens the eyes of the blind. Blessed is the eternal our God, who provides clothes for the naked. Blessed is the eternal our God, who brings freedom to the captive. Blessed is the eternal our God, whose power lifts up the poor. Blessed is the eternal our God, who makes firm each person's steps. Blessed is the eternal our God, who gives our people Israel with strength. Blessed is the eternal our God, who crowns Israel with glory. Blessed is the eternal our God, who gives strength to the weary. Blessed is the eternal our God, who removes sleep from the eyes and slumber from the eyelids. We continue on page 292 with Psalm 92, Psalm for the Shabbat. Mizmor shir liyom haShabbat, tov ladom ladonai lezamer l'shimcha elyon, v'fagid baboker chasdecha, v'mitcha ba'aledot, alei asur ve'alei nabel, alei kinyon v'chinur. It is good to give thanks to the Lord, to sing hymns to your praise, your name, O Most High. Tell of your love in the morning, to sing a night of your faithfulness, to pluck the strings, to sound the lute, to make the harp vibrate. Your deeds, O God, fill me with gladness. Your works make me move to song. How great are your works, O Lord, how profound your design. The fool will never learn this, the dullard will never grasp this. The wicked may flourish like grass, all who do evil may blossom. They are doomed to destruction. While you, O God, you are exalted for all times. See how your enemies, O God, see our enemies, O God, shall perish. How all who do evil shall be scattered. You lift up my head in pride, I am bathed in freshening oil, and shall see the defeat of my foes. My ears shall hear of their fall. The righteous shall flourish like palm, grow tall like cedars in Lebanon. Rooted in the house of the Lord, they shall be forever fresh and green, proclaiming that the Lord is just, my rock, in whom there is no wrong. Continue with the offer, page 294. Oh.
hold with steadfast love your creatures with tender mercy. You neither slumber nor sleep. You awaken the sleeping and arouse the dormant. You give speech to the silent, freedom to the enslaved, and justice to the oppressed. To you alone we give thanks.
The Lord now should overflow with song as the sea. Our tongue is with melody as the roaring waves. Our lips with praise as the heaven's wise chants. And our eyes to shine as the sun and the moon. Our arms extend like eagle's wings. Our feet spread swiftly as the deer. Still we could not fully thank you, Lord our God, the God of all ages.
But bless your name and love.
Even one of your infinite graces
to our ancestors and to us. Therefore, O God, limb and tongue and heart and mind shall all join to praise your name. Every tongue will yet affirm it, and every soul give you a peace. As it is written, all my limbs shall say, Lord, who is like you? And David said, bless the Lord, O my soul, and let all that is within me bless his holy name. Ha'el v'chatzimu v'zeha, ha'gadol v'mo sh'emeha, ha'gor v'netza v'chamara v'nateha, ha'melech ha'yoshay, v'chisei v'mbeni yisa, sh'abina v'moro v'chadol sh'emo, v'chatzimu v'nanu t'agidim v'aronai, v'chamim n'abacha t'ahila, the fish are in the law, who can raise the leaf before the law, who will charm the deep keep no man, who carries Kadashim, keep Kadash. And the assembled hosts of your people, the house of Israel, in every generation, O King, glorify your name in song, O sovereign God, great and holy. Let your name be praised forever in heaven and on earth.
Blessed is the Lord, the sovereign God, the Lord of wonders, who delights in song, the only one, the light of the universe.
May we magnify God's name in the words of the Hatzikach. Yigara, Yigara, Shimei, Baba.
Shinantam Lada,
Udipar Tarvam, Vishitaka Vaitera, Vavetaka Vaitera, Ushakata Kumeka.
You shall love the Lord your God with all your mind, with all your strength, with all your being.
Set these words which I command you today upon your heart. Teach them faithfully to your children. Speak of them in your home and on your way.
When you lie down or when you rise up.
Bind them as a sign upon your hand. Let them be a symbol before your eyes.
Inscribe them on the doorposts of your house and on your gates.
Number one,
Tzitzeru, Ba'asinchem, and Kohl's Vokai. Yitzhem Kiroshim, Leila Penina. Ayi Adonai, Leila Penina. Asher Monsetia, and the Eretz Yisrael. Yod Bakan, Leila Penina. Ayi Adonai.
So you consecrate yourselves to your God. I, the Lord, am your God, who led you out of Egypt to be your God. I, the Lord, am your God. True of your journey, beloved and precious, awesome, good, and beautiful, is the eternal teaching.
This truth we hold to be forever certain. The eternal God is our song. He is the rock of Jacob, our protecting shield.
He abides the world. He abides through all generations. His name is eternal. His throne stands firm. His sovereignty and faithfulness are everlasting.
God's words live and endure, true and precious to all eternity.
Lord our God, you redeemed us from Egypt.
You set us free from the house of bondage.
For this, the people who felt your love sang songs of praise to you.
The living God, mighty and exalted, mighty and awesome.
Who humbles the proud and raises the lowly, who frees the captive and redeems the oppressed.
Who is the answer to all of our acts of God?
All praise to God, Most High, source of blessing. Like Moses and Israel, we sing to him this song of rejoicing.
Thank you.
continue on the top of page 309 with a prayer for the Shabbat.
You are the rock of our life, the power that shields us in every age.
Thank you, it's in your praises. For our lives, which are in your hand. For our souls, which are in your keeping. The signs of your presence we encounter every day. And for your wondrous gifts at all times, morning, noon, and night. You are goodness, your mercies never end. You are compassion, your love will never fail. You have always been our Lord. For all these things, O Sovereign God, that your name be forever exalted and blessed. Our God and Redeemer, let all who live affirm you and praise your name in truth. Lord, whose nature is goodness, we give you thanks and praise. Baruch Atarai. Service continues with the Sim Shalom, page 313. The Sim Shalom, a prayer for peace, followed by a few moments of the prayers of our own hearts. tradition teaches us, there's the Shelet Kabbalah, the chain of tradition of reading and studying the Torah. It goes all the way back to Moses, according to tradition, received the Torah on Mount Sinai. And Moses taught the Torah to Joshua. Joshua taught and studied Torah with the men of the great assembly, with the judges, I mean. And the judges passed the Torah on to the prophets. The prophets are on to the sages and the men and women of the great assembly throughout the generations. Our people have studied and learned from this Torah. Throughout the generations, our people have taken this Torah wherever we have gone. And we have used this Torah as the blueprint for the world in which we would choose to live. On this Shabbat morning, we pass this Torah on to another generation. This Torah, Danny, now will become yours. As your great-grandmother before you, and your grandmother and your mother, and now you. It now becomes your privilege and your responsibility to hold on to this Torah, to cherish this Torah, to love this Torah, to read it and study it, and pass it on to those whom you will love, to those who you will teach. From your great-grandmother who learned and studied Torah and taught it to your grandmother, who passed the Torah on to your mother. On this Shabbat morning, Danny, she passes it on to you.
Baruch Shem Atah.
Please be seated. Our Torah reading for this Shabbat morning is taken from Parshat Vayikachel. It tells of Moses gathering the people together and giving them the instructions for the building of the tabernacle. The Torah portion, though, starts out with something most unusual on some level. Moses says, come and listen to what we're going to do, listen to everything God told us to do in terms of the building of the tabernacle. And what's the first thing Moses tells them? Celebrate Shabbat. Celebrate Shabbat, remember the Shabbat, and anyone who does work on the Shabbat is a great wrong. In fact, that person shall die. You have to wonder, wait a second. Here we are told to build God's house, to build a tabernacle, the place in which God's dwelling will be. What's the first thing we're told to do? Celebrate Shabbat. Remember the day of rest. And our tradition comes to understand, as much as it might be important to build a sanctuary, and to go out in the world to do God's work and to build places and to build ways in which God's dwelling might be within us and within the world, what takes a higher priority than that? The idea of being able to step back from the world, be able to celebrate Shabbat. And what is Shabbat? Well, Shabbat takes us back to the story of creation. And the story is that on the seventh day, God rested, and God, Vayikinafash, is the Hebrew word. Translated as rested or re-ensouled God's self. And so what do we do on Shabbat? It is the day of the week when we can stop doing our normal everyday activities. And what are our normal everyday activities? They're all involved with the process of creating. No matter what it is we do, we create. Whether it is creating for Intel, creating for the government, creating for whoever. 6 days a week. We're involved in the process of creating things and ideas. And what do we do on Shabbat? We step back and we enjoy that creation. We step back and say, this is not a day to create, but rather a day to enjoy creation, to enjoy our families, our community, to study, just to relax. A day to just be and not to do. We as a society are so caught up with do. This is a day where it's okay just to be. Christian teaches us, and the Torah says, we should not create any fires. Last night, as we celebrated Shabbat, as we began Shabbat, as I think it was grandma and our great aunt lit the Shabbat candles, what did you do? They covered their eyes. Why? It's an old tradition that goes back to probably hundreds of years, based upon this week's Torah portion. Torah says, do not light any fire on Shabbat. You've got a problem. Once you said the blessing for the lighting of the candles, Shabbat has begun. And if Shabbat has begun, then you can't light a fire. But if I'm saying the blessing over candles, how do I do this? Tradition created a legal loophole. First, light the candles, then cover your eyes and say the blessings. And when you open your eyes, it's as if you've lit the candles for the very first time. And you wonder why Jews make good tax accountants. You figure out the legal loophole. Many people, though, say, what else do we do as we cover our eyes? People have a tendency to bring their arms and bring the light and the warmth of those candles in. Think about some of the good things that have happened during this past week. Bring that with you into Shabbat. And as you cover your eyes, all the bad stuff and the crap that's happened, walk that out. It's Shabbat. It doesn't matter anymore. Now is the time to enjoy Shabbat. And for those who want to follow the reading of our Torah portion, may be found beginning on page 373 of our Chumash. Page 373 for those who took Chumash from the back of the sanctuary. Joseph Ross.
Arbonu mikol, aminu klinot, amonu et oroko, oroka tarunai no tena Torah.
Amen. Vayikachel Moshe et kol adat b'nei Yisrael, and Moses gathered all the people of Israel. Vayomer aleichem, and he said to them, Eilech adivarim asher tziva Adonai la'asot, O Tom. These are the things which God has commanded us to do, commanded you to do. Sheshit yamim ta'aseh malacha. 6 days you shall do all of your labor. Uvayom hashvi'i yelechem kodesh. And the seventh day shall be holy unto you. Shabbat shabbaton l'adonai. It is the Sabbath, a day of complete rest unto your God. Kol ha'aseh bo malacha yumat. Anyone who does labor on it shall die. Lo ta'avru esh b'chol mashvotechem b'yom ha'shabbat. You shall not light a fire in any of your dwellings on the day of Shabbat.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech olam asher matan lanu torat emet b'chayei olam notah b'tokeinu Baruch atah Adonai notein ha'torah.
Yamod Yosef ben Deborah Sheni. Second Aliyah, we call upon Joseph Santo.
Yet Kokoret, Yet Kokorochet, Amasa, Yet Ashukar,
the etfadah, and all the things for the tabernacle and the ark and all their attachments, and the table and all of its attachments and all of its stands, v'et kol kelav and all of its instruments, v'et lechem hapanim and the showbreads, v'et menorot nahor and the lamp for lighting up things, v'et kelav and all of its attachments and all of its instruments, v'et menorotecha and all of its lamps, v'et shemen hamaoroi and the oil for the lighting, v'et mizbach hakatoret and the altar for the incense burner, v'et adav and its poles, v'et shemen hamishchah and the oil for the anointing, v'et ketoret hasamim and the for the incense burners, v'et masach hatochat liftach hamishkan and the coverings for it and the coverings that should go around the tent of the meeting, v'et mizbach ha'olah and the altar for the burnt offering, v'et michbar hanechoshet asher lo and the brass grill. Think of a burner, think of a fireplace. You've got the place where the fire burns, and you've got the grill on top. That's what this is. V'et bata, v'et kol kelav, and all of its instruments. Notice each of these things are coming with all of their instruments and their poles, because all of this is being made in such a way that it is transportable easily. Remember, the Jews now are living in the desert. They're building the first tabernacle, which will be carried with them for the 40 years of wandering. So this all needs to be able to be broken down into small pieces so it can be easily carried. Every person went out from before them, and they went and they took b'chol asher nidav, Brucho Oto, and everyone whose heart was filled with wisdom. Heviu et Rumat Ananar, and everyone brought the gift of God. L'malchalit Ochel Moed, for it to be worked and to be brought to the tent of meeting. U'l'chol Avodotav u'l'chol Didei HaKodesh, Vayavu HaNashim, Al HaNashim, and the men and the women, they went holy day play. Everyone whose heart was filled with wisdom. Heviu Achad and Hazachad, the Nezim, the Tabaad, the Purmo, the Hamad, Hol Kalei Zachad. They went and they got earrings and rings and bracelets, everything that was made of gold. Hol Ish Asher Hanitu Fa, Zachad, Ladanoi. They all brought all this gold and silver and all sorts of things to God. The Hol Ish Asher Nitsa Oto Tehelet Bar Gamam, the Tola Cheni, the Shesh Izim, the Rod Elim Adumim, the Rod Tehashim, and everyone who had blue and purple and crimson yarns, and everyone who had seal skins and all sorts of other precious objects, they went and brought them. Hol Marim, Umat Kesem, the Nechoshet Tadibi, and everybody who had gold and silver, they brought those also. Et Rumat Adonai, they brought them all as a gift to God. V'chol asher nimtza oto etzei shittim, and everyone who had acacia wood, v'chol malachat haviu, and everyone who had acacia wood that could be worked, they brought that, haviu, v'chol asher chokmat le biyada, and everyone, and v'chol isha, I'm sorry, and every woman whose hands were filled with wisdom also, tabu, dei wo, haviu matot et hatachalit, all the women who had woven things, they brought those also. And what the Torah finally concludes by telling us, the people kept on bringing and bringing and bringing. And what did Moses finally have to tell them? Enough already. We've got more than we can possibly use. It was the first Jewish building campaign ever, and the only one that's ever been oversubscribed.
I didn't know.
Forgot to tell you, huh? of the king, and it tells of King Solomon and the building of the tabernacle. And in the Torah portion spoke not about all the things that the people brought, but it also then goes on to tell us who the artisan was, who the chief architect was, and that was Bezalel. It wasn't really the architect, I guess we would call him the general contractor. God was the architect, Bezalel was the general contractor. So too, when Solomon went to go build his temple, Hiram was the general contractor who was filled with wisdom, filled with the wisdom of God. It goes into just as much detail of telling us how Hiram, under Solomon's command, built the first temple that stood in Jerusalem. For those who'd like to follow the Torah, HaTorah, page 382 of our Chumashim, page 382.
Rachel, hey, I'll see you. He be high in the wild, wild, and fresh, toshy.
Showing I flipped a coin to see who was going to have to read this, and obviously I lost. This is truly a day for celebration, extreme pride, and honor. We are here to celebrate one of the most important milestones in Danny's religious education. We celebrate his accomplishment and commitment, not only as a Jewish man, but also as a fine human being. We applaud his persistency, his perseverance, to successfully reach this point in his religious training. We know all too well that Danny has never lacked for persistency nor perseverance. 13 years ago tomorrow, Danny came into our lives with a great deal of drama. Circumstances were such that he had his first helicopter ride that day. Danny has always done things in a big way. During his year in kindergarten, his teacher asked us to come see her. She told us that Danny was a wonderful student. However, he needed to stop tearing up other children's papers and telling them that they can do better. And to start again. His fifth grade teacher called us into her conference and told us that Danny was a wonderful student. However, he made her very tired each day with all of the questions he asked her to answer. If she couldn't answer his questions to his satisfaction, she knew that she would have to research the topic and have an answer for him the next day. She said she could bet money that he would ask her again. Danny has filled us with pride over the past 13 years, with honor roll credits, awards and citations, good sportsmanship awards, and the list is endless. It doesn't surprise us that he has very high standards and aspirations. We have all been witness to his success of today. His father and I have had the privilege to watch him grow each day into this fine young man who stands before us today. We have tried to teach him to be honest, fair, compassionate, reasonable, and most of all, to be proud of himself. Joe and I see today that we have been successful in our task, and our hearts are filled with pride. Though we know that our job is far from over, we agree that, so far, we've done a fine job. Please understand, not every day was a day to celebrate. Most of you here know Danny pretty well. You know that he has his stubborn side and his strong sense of self-reliance. These qualities make life with Danny a challenge. It is these very challenges that have caused us to never lack for comic relief from him, or to think of it from his brother or sister either. Our family is truly blessed with the gift of laughter. It can really be a tension breaker. We are therefore honored to have Danny as our son and wish him further outstanding successes. In his achievement today, Danny especially honors his Zadie, his Bubby, his father, and I by fulfilling a lifelong dream. I know that his Bubby is proud of him as she sits here smiling and crying. I know that his Zadie is smiling down on him from heaven. And Joe and I can only say to him, Danny, thank you from the bottom of our hearts for being you. Therefore, we celebrate Danny and his success. He has filled us with pride, and we are honored to have him as our son.
Not one of the top 10s in terms of excitement or great ideas in it. It's one of those Torah portions that's difficult to read and to say, what is it trying to teach us in our lives in 1999? If I was an architect, if I was a fashion designer, if I was a jeweler, a worker of gold and precious stones, it might be fascinating. But I'm not. As far as I know, you're not yet either. Maybe you will be. We have to step back and say, what is this Torah portion trying to teach us? And our rabbis, who were not architects, who were not seamstresses and fashion designers, who were not gold and silver, they struggled with the same questions. And then they stopped and asked, wait a second, where did the B'nai Yisrael get the gold and the silver and all the fine things that they used to build the tabernacle? And what did they suddenly discover? Just last week, what did they build? Just last week in our Torah reading, they had built the golden calf. The same gold and silver, the same precious stones and everything else that they used to build the golden calf, so too, they used those same things to build the tabernacle. As our rabbis taught us, with their earrings and their gold, they sinned. With their earrings and their gold, they restored themselves to God's favor. What were the rabbis trying to teach us? That the very same things that we misuse, we can also use to great benefit and great skill. Just think about our world. Think about the possessions and all the great things that we as humanity have created. One of the greatest inventions and discoveries of our century is what? The amazing drugs that our society and our chemists and pharmacists have developed. With those same drugs that we use to bring health and healing to one another and to people, what do we know can happen when those drugs are misused? Lives. Destroyed. All you have to do is walk down almost any street in America. You will see people taking almost the exact same drugs. Some are using those drugs in the way in which they are meant to be used, and their lives are enhanced and made richer and prolonged because of their proper use of those drugs. And other people on that exact same street are abusing and misusing those drugs. And destroying their lives, and destroying the communities and their friends and family around them. Think of the atom. With that ability, we have learned how to smash the atom and create amazing amounts of energy. Some of that energy can be used to create electricity. That same power, that same energy, we know can be used to destroy the entire world. Nuclear bombs, where other people speak about the laser. Probably there are some people here who've had laser surgery done, which have brought sight back to their eyes and healing and wisdom and all sorts of other things. And that same laser, once again, can be used for complete destruction. The question isn't what we have, but how we use it. Do we use it, or do we misuse it? Whether it is the sins of science, whether it is the physical possessions that we each have, our money and our goods and our services, do we use them to glorify ourselves, or do we use them to build a better community and a better family? And just as that might be true of physical things, so our rabbis teach us, it is true of our emotions too. Skepticism, being a doubter. One student once came to the rabbi and said, Rabbi, what good is skepticism? All it does is it leads people to doubt the very existence of God. And the rabbi said, yes, that's true of skepticism when it's misused. But when it's used properly, that very doubting of God, what does it lead us to do? It leads us to pray as is everything dependent on God. But to act as if God doesn't exist. To act as if everything depends on me. What does that skepticism lead you to, Danny? It says, God, please help us make this world a better place. But while I'm waiting for your help, God, going to go out and do those tasks myself. I'm going to make this world a better place. And the same thing can happen when misfortunes happen to us. There's a story told of Rabbi Gratz. He was appointed to his first rabbinic position, and the congregation asked him to come and give a trial sermon. When he was giving a trial sermon, he got completely nervous and flustered. His sermon came out almost to be complete gibberish. And what happened? The job he thought he landed, this great job, he was immediately fired. What did Gratz go and do, though? Gratz realized that he was not filled with the wisdom to be a pulpit rabbi. He was filled with the wisdom. He was given God's gift to be a great scholar. Out of the ashes of having lost that dream job, he became one of the greatest Jewish historians ever to live. He lived in the mid-1800s, and his history texts are still used by scholars because he went from misfortune and used it for goodness. Danny, if I had to think about one of the lessons of your Torah portion is, it is the lesson that Judaism is trying to teach all of us. We have amazing things in front of us. We all have amazing skills and abilities. When we use those skills and abilities to bring Kedusha, to bring holiness into the world, or will we use those skills and abilities and those things to bring evil and destruction into our world? And where does the choice lie? The choice lies with each of us. In a few years, you grow up a little bit, and you're out with your friends. Will you use your brain and the skills that you have to save your friend who's had too much to drink, give me the car keys, so that we can all get home safe? Will we use those same car keys to go out your life and perhaps to kill yourself or hurt others? When you get older, will you use the brains that you have, the skills that you have, to bring to your shop, to bring justice? You talked about wanting to be a judge. Will you bring justice into this world? Or will you, and each of us, just focus on ourselves? Today, as we celebrate your bar mitzvah, from what we know, what I know of you, and what your mom spoke of you, we know that you will be one of those who will know how to use the gifts that you have been given. That you will be one of those who will know how to create and bring holiness into the world. Who will know how to be a true Jew in this world. A person who says, let me use my skills and abilities and possessions to make this world a better place. Because I am a skeptic. Because I am a skeptic. Because I doubt in God on some levels, and therefore, I'll do it myself while I wait for God to come and help me to it. On this Shabbat, we reaffirm our faith in God. We ask God's blessing upon you. Mishaber HaMetzim Abraham Yitzhak Yaakov, Sarah Alim Aleh Rachel. Our God bless our ancestors, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, Sarah, Rebecca, Rachel, and Leah. Tein Bracha, grant and provide blessing to Daniel ben Devorah. May he be filled with wisdom. May he, throughout his life, strive to find the godly given gifts that he has been given. May you again use those gifts to bring Kedusha, to bring holiness into our world, to make our world a better place. We so live and you so live. And we all say we've had the honor and privilege of knowing him, seeing the good deeds that he has done throughout his life. May this be our blessings. May it be God's blessing. Let us all say amen. Amen.
I get to represent the Board of Trustees and the Sisterhood this morning. First, I'd like to say that I'm sorry the cantor is sick, but I am thrilled that I had the honor and privilege of sharing the meeting with you today. It was wonderful, wonderful, and inspiring. Okay, from the Board of Trustees, you have a certificate. And a couple of certificates worth money. This one is a $200 scholarship if you participate in an Israel experience program, and another $250 gift certificate if you go on a Travel to Israel Nifty summer program. So, wow. Those are very nice. And also from the Board of Trustees, a wonderful prayer book called On the Doorpost of Your House, Prayers and Ceremonies for the Jewish Home. And
continues with the returning of the Torah to the Ark, page 422, with the opening of the Ark we call on Sheila and Lee Kopelman, page 422. We all rise as the Torah and the Ark are opened.